हेलो स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ। टुडे वी स्टार्ट अवर लेसन नंबर 6, दैट इज मोर फीचर्स ऑफ एमएस वर्ड 2010। नाउ यू ऑल नो दैट एमएस वर्ड 2010 इज अ वर्ड डॉक्यूमेंट प्रोसेसिंग प्रोग्राम। यू कैन क्रिएट, एडिट, प्रिंट एंड सेव डॉक्यूमेंट इन एमएस वर्ड 2010 एज वेल एज 2007। नाउ how to start ms word 2007 or else 2010, you can just type here ms word 2010 or else you can type word. So you can see here microsoft word 2010. Now this is our Microsoft Word window. Now this is called Word button, this is called ribbon, these all are tabs. This is minimize, maximize and close button, this is scroll bar, and this is ruler bar, and this is our working area. Now this is called status bar. Now ribbon contain tabs and groups. This is tabs, and in tabs you can see here many groups are there, that is pages, tables, illustration, links. In home menu you can see clipboard, font, paragraph, style. Now in page layout you can see theme, page setup. So this is all our groups, and each groups are many options like bold, italic, underline. You can see here change size, change font style, alignment, border. In insert tab you can see picture, clip art, shape. So this is all are in groups. Now how to type the text in a document? After you have created document, you are ready to start typing in your document. So you can see here small blink vertical line in working area. This is the insertion point. It appears in the upper left corner of your Word page. This is the point from where you will start typing your text. Now I am from Surat. So you can see here text. The insertion point move to the right as you type. Do not press enter key when you come to the end of the line. Now suppose I want to type in next line, so you can press enter key on your keyboard. So you can see here now my cursor move to the into the next line. Now I am typing some paragraph here. You can see here I type 3 paragraph. Now how to select the text? You can select text by using keyboard or mouse or a combination of both devices. Now first you can see using keyboard. Now to select the text using keyboard, position the cursor to the left of first character from where you wish to select the text. Hold down the shift key and move the cursor by using the keyboard. Now first is to select one character to the right. Now I press shift key and the right arrow from keyboard. So you can see here my text is selected from right side. Now to select one character to the left side, so you can, my cursor is here. Now I press the shift key and left arrow, so you can see my text will be select from the left side. Now to select one line up, so now I want to select the whole line, so I press the shift key and up arrow. So you can see here my one line will be selected फ्रॉम अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. नाउ टू सिलेक्ट वन लाइन डाउन, सो आई प्रेस शिफ्ट की एंड डाउन की एरो. सो यू कैन सी हियर माई वन लाइन विल बी सिलेक्टेड. नाउ टू लाइन, थ्री लाइन, फोर लाइन. सो यू कैन इजिली सिलेक्ट टैक्स यूजिंग शिफ्ट की एंड एरो की. नाउ टू सिलेक्ट टू द एंड ऑफ द करंट लाइन. नाउ सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू सिलेक्ट द होल लाइन, सो यू कैन प्रेस शिफ्ट प्लस एंड एंड. सो यू कैन सी माई होल लाइन विल बी सिलेक्टेड. Now to select to the end of the document, so you can first of all press the cursor here. Now press the key from keyboard, shift, control, end. So you can see here my whole document will be selected. Now to select the beginning of the document, so you can press the cursor here. Now press shift control plus home, so you can see my whole document will be selected. Now to select the entire document, so you can press control plus A, that means select all. So you can see here my whole document will be selected. Now using mouse to select the text using mouse, you can first cursor, put the cursor here. Now hold down the left mouse button and drag it to the end point of the selection. You can select like this or as you can select like this. Suppose I want to select one line, so you can select one line. Suppose I want to select two lines, so you can select two lines. Your selected text will be highlighted. Now next topic is how to insert picture in MS Word. You can insert the picture from a file in your document. To insert a picture, you can just go into the insert menu and click on picture. Click on picture. So one dialog box is open. You can see here one dialog box is open. Now I want to select folder from my drive. So my picture is in E drive and here my picture, that is Indian flag and insert. So you can see the Indian flag will be inserted in the our document. Now I delete this. So first of all, you can select the picture and press delete key from your keyboard. So your image will be deleted. Now how to insert clip art. Clip art is a collection of several picture and symbols stored in MS Word program. You can insert this picture in your document. Now how to insert clip art. So you can just click on insert menu and you can see clip art option is illustration group. So you can press clip art. So in right side you can see clip art dialog box is open. Now suppose I want to search the car image, so I type here car and just click on go. So you can see here three cars are available in MS Word. So I want to put this image in your document, so I click on this image. So we can easily import picture in our document. So you can see here our picture will be imported in our document. Now suppose I want to insert this image, or else you can search, suppose I write computer. So write computer and just press on go. So you can see here many computer images are available in document. So you can just press one image, so you can easily put image in our document. Now our next topic is how to insert shapes in MS Word. Now you can just click on insert tab and you can see here shape option drop down. You can press on shapes you can see here many shapes are available. Now suppose I want to draw a smiley face, so you can select smiley shapes and draw here like this. So you can see here our shapes in our document. Now you can see here blue color is in our shapes. Now I want to change this color. So you can see here shapes fill options are there. You can click on. Now select any color from color. Suppose I choose yellow color. So you can see here yellow color is in our shape. Now suppose I want to change red. So you can see here red color is in our shape. Now next topic is insert word art. Word art allow you to insert different style of text in your document. It makes the document more attractive and presentable. Now you can first write text. Suppose I type Surat. Now first of all you can select the Surat text. Now you can just click on insert tab and you can see here word art option in text group. You can select word art. Now you can see here different style of word art. You can select one of them. Suppose I select this word art style. Now you can see here our text will be changed in word art. Now again I want to change. So you can see here format tab is there. So you can click on the style and you can select one of them. Suppose I select this text. So you can see here word art will be changed in our style. Now our next topic is how to change the case of the letter. In MS Word 2010, you can convert the letter of the text from the lowercase to the uppercase. You do not have to type the whole text once again for changing the case of the letter. To change the case, you can just, first of all, you can select the text like this and just go into the home tab and you can see here change case option is there. Now this letter is in our sentence case. Sentence case means first letter capital and all other letter will be in small letter. Now suppose I want to change into the uppercase, so I select this paragraph and you can just click on change case option and you can select uppercase. So whole the paragraph will come into the uppercase. Now again I want to change in lowercase, so whole paragraph will come into the lowercase. Now suppose I want to change in capitalize each word, that means each word first character will be in capital letter. So you can see here on O will be capital, the will be, T will be capital, insert I will be capital, tab T will be capital. So this means capitalize each word. Now last options is toggle case. So you can see here first letter in smaller and all other letter will be in capital letter. So this is capital letter and first is sentence case. So you can see here this is in our sentence case. So this is our change case. Now how to add page color in our document. You can also apply color to the entire page in MS Word. You can just click on page layout menu and page color options is there. You can just click on page color. There are many colors. You can select one of them. Suppose I am selecting blue color. So whole document will be page color will be in blue color. Suppose I want to change page color in yellow. So I click on yellow color, show our page color in yellow color. Now suppose I want to remove that page color. So you can just click on page color and no color. Select no color option. So you can see here our color will be removed from our page. Now next topic is print preview. When you have finished typing your text and you wish to print the document, before printing you can see how your document will look. So you can just click on file menu and you can click on print option. So you can see here print preview options is available. So you can change your style or page color, page border from there. Now next topic is how to print a document. So you can just click on file menu and click on print. Now in print there are many options. First is print selection. You can just click on this drop down. So you can see here print selection options is there. Print selection means print the part of the document that is selected. That means you can select your text and just go into the file and print. That means if you select this option, you can only print your selected portion of the text. Now print all pages. That means printed all pages in your printed all pages from your document. Now print current page. That means print the single page that is view on the screen. And print custom range allow you to specify page specifically need to be printed or a range of pages to be printed. I hope you all are understand this practical. Thank you for watching this video.